Hello everyone. Up to the now, in this chapter, we had discussed about what is the build drive, in which different types of build will be used in the market as per the applications we studies related to the build drive. Today, in this lecture, we will discuss about rope drive as well as the chain drive. Okay. So this chapter is concerned with the belt, rope and chain. So we know that the three parts belt, rope and chain is the power transmission device, in which today we will cover here the rope drive section and also concerned with the chain drive section. Rope drive, that means what? The rope drive are widely used in the large amount of the power. Okay. So in a belt drive, we discuss about the V belt, also concerned with the flat belt and circular belt. It is the concern with the light, medium and heavy drive. So in rope drive, widely used for the large amount of power is to transmit from the one pulley to the another pulley over the consideration of the distance. Okay. So it may be noted that the use of the flat belt is limited for the transmission of power. We know that it is the 8 meter apart. Okay. So whenever we require 8 meter apart, that time we use the rope drive. Okay. So rope drive are used in two categories. First of all, there is the two types of the rope drive are in a use, that is called as a fiber ropes. Okay. And another is the wire ropes. What is the fiber ropes? Fiber ropes, that means what we can made from the fiber. So that is called as a fiber rope. Another thing is the wire ropes. Okay, wire rope, that means what it will be made from the wires, that is called as a metal wires. Another things will be a concern with the wire ropes. But most important thing is to the transmit the power from the one pulley to another pulley. So that is the concern with the fiber ropes. Fiber ropes are generally used for the 60 meters apart, and the wire ropes will be used for the 150 meters apart. So that is the most effective applications of the rope drive, in which flat belt drive we can use only the 8 meters apart, but in the fiber ropes it will be a 60 meters, and wire ropes it will be a 150 meters. That is the main advantage of the rope drive. Okay, what is the advantage of the fire ropes drive as compared to the belt drive? Okay, they give the smooth and steady and quiet service. Okay, we know that. And they are little affected by the outdoor condition, because it made from the fibers, so it will be not affected by the moisture and soil in so that is the most effective in the outdoor conditions. Another is the start may be out of the strike alignment. Okay, so in a belt drive, we know that the one theory is concerned with the slipping of the belt. This drawback is overcome in the shaft may be a sticking to alignment, so the slipping of the belt in the fiber and wire ropes, it will be overcome. The power may be taken off in any directions, and frictions part of the whole amount. Okay, so we can power will be taken from the clockwise to anti-clockwise, anti-clockwise to clockwise, in one pulley to another pulley. That will be we can use the ideal pulley. In this, we can use in any directions of the part. Okay, so they give the high mechanical efficiency. That is the advantage of the fire ropes. Okay. Another is concerned with the wire ropes. We know that as shown in figure, these types of arrangement will be a concern with the wire rope. In wire ropes, we can use for the heavy materials. We can carrying the heavy material from the one place to the another place. We can see these types of arrangement will be used in the construction sites, also concerned with the loading and unloading of the machines. So that will be used for the wire ropes. In applications of the wire rope, we know that it will be a transmit used for the transmit the power from one pulley to another pulley, and carrying the material from the one place to the another place at the 150 meters. Okay, so that is the basic advantage of the wire ropes. Okay, so what is the driving ratio, driving tension of the rope drive, and also concerned with the wire ropes? Okay, so in the belt drive, we know that there is the ratio 2.3 log T1 by T2 equal to mu theta. Okay, but 2.3 log T1 by T2 mu theta is the concern with what? it is the slack side and tight side tension. Okay, but whenever we require the, that is called as a mu theta, that is called as a cosec beta, that time that is the concern with the driving tension to the slack side to the tight side to the slack side. That time we can use that is called as a 2.3 log T1 by T2 equal to mu theta and cosec beta. Okay, that is the ratio of the driving tension from the one pulley to the another pulley for the rope drives. Okay, so now we can see here the one examples regarding the rope drive. In example, the data is concerned with the rope drive, the transmit the power that is called as a P 600 kilowatt from a pulley effective diameter. The diameter is given here the 4 meter, and which runs at of speed of the 90 rpm. That is the 90 that is called as the N, that is 90 rpm, and the angle of flap is 160. That is theta. Theta is given here the 160, and the angle of groove. Though in previous equations we had considered here, that is the in previous equations 2.3 log T1 by T2 mu theta cosec beta. The beta is concerned with the, that is the call as an angle of groove. Okay, so the coefficient of the frictions, we know that is the mu equal to 0.28, and the mass of the rope is 1.5 kg. okay, and the available tension in each rope is, that is called as a 2400 newtons. Find the number of ropes in which whenever give the we can design the any types of rope in the transmit the power from the one pulley to the another pulley, also concerned with the one sub to the another sub. That time the rope drive is transmit, how much rope will be used, because it will be carrying the capacity. Each and rope will be according to its diameter, its length. So a rope drive transmit the six, in this example the rope drive transmit the 600 kilowatt. Okay, so P equal to 600 kilowatt is given. That effective diameter, we know that is the D equal to 4 meter, and it will be run at 90 rpm. And the angle of lap, that is called as a theta, is given 160, and the angle of groove is 450, that is called as a beta. The coefficient of the frictions is given, mu equal to 0.28, and the mass of the rope is 1.5 kg per meter. The available tension, that is called as another in the brakes and clutches, that is the call as a torquing of the brakes, T, that is here considered here, that is the available tension in the each rope. So that is called as a 2400 newtons. Okay, so how much rope will be required to transmit the power, okay, according to the 600 kilowatt from the one pulley to the another pulley, so we can find out. Okay, we know that the what is the velocity ratio, V equal to pi D n by 60. Okay, so here n is given here, that is called as a 90. From this equation we can find the velocity of the rope. So that is called as a 18.85 meter per second. That means what each rope velocity is concerned here, the 18.85 meter per second. Okay, and another is a centrifugal tension, that is called as a TC. So TC equal to mv square. We know that is the concern with the 1/2 mv square. So m is the concern with the, that is the mass, and mass is given here the 1.5 meters kg per meter. Okay, so TC is the concern with the mv square. So then centrifugal tension TC is mv square for 533 newtons. Okay, and the tension in the tight side, and slack side, we know that what is the slack side, in a tension in the tight side, that is called as a overall tension minus centrifugal tension. So here the T1 is the tight side. Okay, so overall tension is given here. So T is the also concerned with the, in another is that concerned with the torquing of the brakes is called as a TB. Okay, so in with T equal to T, T1 equal to T minus TC. So T1 equal to 1867 and T2 equal to tension in the slack side. Okay, so we know that the what is the equation, 2.3 log T1 by T2 mu cosec beta. Theta is the angle of lap and beta is the angle of groove in a given in the your example. So from these equations we can find out the ratio of T1 and T2. Okay, so T1 and T2 ratio is the 7.786. Okay, so T2 equal to T1 by 7.786. From this equation, T2 equal to 240 Newton. So we can find out, we know that the what is the permissible transmission for rope, T1 minus T2 into V. So from this equation, 1867 minus 7, 2.240. So we can find out the power transmission, that is called the 3067 kilowatt. But your power will be given here, that is called as a 600 kilowatt. Okay, the total power required 600. Okay, but power transmitted per rope, that is called as a 3.60. So from this equation, we can find out the number of rope. So it is the 20. Okay, so whenever in this, from this example, we can find out that the in which the 60 kilowatt power will be a required, diameter is the 4 meters, and the kg of the mass of the rope per meter is 1.5 kg. That time the 20 rope will be required to transmit the power from the one pulley to the another pulley, or carrying the shaft for the one place to the another place. Okay, so that is the this one is the case study for the how much and the number, how much rope will be required to transmit the power from the one pulley to the another pulley. Okay, so another is the concern with the chain drive. Okay, I think we all of you are aware with the chain from the our childhood, that is called as a bicycle chain. In which, what is the chain drive? So up to the now, we can transmit the power from the one pulley to the another pulley by the belt, by the rope. But here, from the we can see in this figure, we can transmit the power from the one pulley to another pulley by using the chain. Okay, so that is called as a chain drive. What chain drive? That means what? A chain drive application is mostly used in the transmit the power from the one shaft to the another when the distance between the center of the shaft is short. We can use in generally in the bicycle, motorcycle, in also used in the agriculture machinery, roads and roller, etc. We know that chain drive mostly, that is the, we can from this figure, that is called as a chain. Okay, and another is the socket. Sprocket is the most important things in the chain drive. So chain drive are mostly used to transmit the power from the shaft to the another when the distance of the very short. They're generally used in the bicycle, also in the motorcycle and agriculture machinery and road. So we can use from this roller and etc. Okay, what is the advantage and disadvantage of the chain drive over the belt drive and rope drive? Okay, so advantage of the chain drive is what, and what is the belt drive and rope drive? So as the no slipping take place during the chain drive, hence the perfect velocity ratio is obtained. So we know that the in arrangement sprockets and chain will be inserted to each other. Okay, so slipping is the not concerned in in a chain drive. So the perfect velocity ratio is obtained. Okay, we know that the what is the velocity ratio? It is the n1 by n2 equal to t1 by t2. That is called as a velocity ratio, or also concerned with the v1 by v2. Okay, so v equal to pi d n by 60. From this equation, we can find out the velocity ratio. So in this, what is the main advantage of the chain drive? That is the concern with the no slipping ratio. Okay, so we can obtain the high velocity ratio. Since the chains are made of the metal, therefore the occupy less space than a belt and rope drive. Okay, we know that the chain generally made from the metal, so it's occupied the less space with than the belt of the rope drive. Okay, and the chain drive may used when the distance between the shaft is less. Okay, whereas the distance between the shaft is less, we know that it will be used for the bicycle, also used in the agriculture machinery. So in the chain drive may be used when the distance is the shaft and less. The chain drive gives the high transmission efficiency up to the 98%. It's a high transmission efficiency. We know that up to the 98%. Okay, it's a very high. And the chain drive gives the least load on the shaft, and the chain drive has the ability to transmit the motions to serve shaft by the one chain only. Okay, generally we can use the belt drive in applications of the number of shaft we can use, okay, number of drive will be used, but in the chain drive has the ability to transmit the motions to serve the sub by a one chain only. That means what? Only one chain will be used to transmit the power from the one sub to the another sub. We cannot use the more than one chain. Okay, so that is the advantage of the chain drive over the built-in rope drive. Okay, what is the disadvantage? The disadvantage is generally the production cost of the chain is relatively high. So because it's generally used from made from the metal, so that is the cost of the chain will be a high. Okay, we know that. And the chain drive needs to accurate mounting and carefully maintenance, because the sprockets and socket will be inserted to each other. So in the manufacturing, the mounting of the carefully is the required. And the chain drive has the velocity fluctuation, especially when the unduly stretch it. Okay, so that means what? It is the concern with the jerk. Okay, in the bicycle and also in the motorcycle, we can give the jerk. That time the chain velocity fluctuation occurs in the unduly stretches. Okay, so that is the advantage and disadvantage of the chain drive over the built-in rope drive. Okay, and generally the terms used in the chain drive, so this is called as a pitch. Pitch, that means what? It is the center distance between the two sprockets. Okay, so that is called as a pitch. From the pitch we can find out the total length of the chain. Okay, so that is the most important term will be used in the chain drive, that is called as a pitch. Another is the higher center, another is the chain, another is the sprockets, and another is the chain link. Okay, chain link, that means what? You can use for the continuously, it will be a carry 1, 2, 3, 4 from this link, we can use it, that is called as a chain link. Okay, another is the classic versions of the chain is the chain with overlink. Chain with overlink, that means what? It will be inserted to the each other, and here we can weld, or that is called as a chain with the overlink. Conveyor chain, that means what? We can use, that is the one link will be attached to the two sprocket, that is called as a conveyor link. Okay, power transmission link, that will be a oval will be each other and concerned with the driving to the driven sub, that is called as a power transmission link. Okay, that is the power transmittance chain, that is called as a block chain. Okay, two block will be inserted to each other, that is called as a power transmission chain. Okay, and another is the boost roller chain. In will be a roller will be used, that is called as a, that is boost type of roller will be used, that is called as a boost roller chain. And another is the inverted tooth or silent chain. Inverted tooth, that means what? In which tooth, that means what? That is called that will be made from the metal by using specially for the inverted tooth. It will be inserted to each other. So velocity ratio and slipping will be not occurs in the inverted tooth of the silent. Okay, that is the inverted tooth silent chain. Okay, so up to the now we had discussed about in this chapter built drive, what is the rope drive and what is the chain drive. Okay, so generally it will be in GTU exam it will be a cover 7 to 10 marks. So generally, what is the application? What is the built drive? In which built drive in examples related to the slip and creep will be a very important for the exam point of view. Thank you very much.